TVE Maths Paper 1, November 2020. In this question, I'll be discussing question 7, which of course deals with derivative or calculus for that matter, right? And of course, if you see f prime x from first principles, then of course you need to remember that this function can only be dealt with in a certain way. So if I go to my formula sheet and look at this formula here, then that is the formula I'll be using. Now take note that the f of x plus h minus the f of x must first be determined. So remember, x plus h must be substituted into the function and x, and you must subtract the 2. So let's do that. So there you are. So this x here must be replaced by x plus h. Right? Simplify, remove the brackets, and you get this. So there you are. That is the x, f of x plus h, and subtract the f of x, which is that function there. Remove the brackets, and you end up with this value. So in the formula, remember I showed you earlier on, this is what I've just calculated now, which is this 4xh plus 2h squared over h. Then, of course, factorize, which must be done. H must be a common factor. If this does not happen, then something is wrong. You must go back and double check your mistakes. Then cancel the h's, and then, of course, the limit of 4x is 4x. Remember the limit of, remember, x is regarded as a constant. So the limit of a constant is the constant. And of course, the limit of 2h is 0. Then the next question, 7.2, you must not use first principles, but rather derivative rules. Now, what you must remember here is that derivatives don't tolerate thirds, fractions, and brackets. So therefore, all of those must first be removed. So let's do the first one. The only problem here is I must get rid of the third. So if I do that, then of course, the fifth root of x squared is x to the power 2 fifths. Take note the way we write it down as well. So 2 fifths times the 1 in front of x is 2 fifths. Then of course, 2 fifths minus 1 is negative 3 fifths. The same here, 3 times 1 is 3. 3 minus 1 is 2. And that's your answer. Then the last one, of course, is, sorry, right. This one here, of course, x cannot be minus 3 over 2 because if we substitute that into the denominator, you get a 0. And of course, division by 0 is not allowed. But I see a fraction, so I need to get rid of the fraction. So therefore, I should recognize maybe this as sum and difference. So factorization should be the key. So there you are, factorize, cancel the two brackets, and you're left with that. Divide 2 into 2x, you get x. Divide 2 into 3, you get 3 over 2. Then, of course, the derivative of x is 1. The derivative of a constant is 0. And that gives you your answer.